My name is Dr. Max Liberon. I'm the Director of Civic Laboratory for Environmental Action Research, or CLEAR, and I draw both on my art and design and scientific background to do what I do now, which is anti-colonial and feminist science. So feminist and anti-colonial science just means you take the values and the premises and the beliefs of feminism, which is about equity, first and foremost, but other values as well, valuing care labor, valuing emotional labor, that sort of stuff, and you bring it into your science. So I didn't come to Baby Legs. Baby Legs came to me. Baby Legs isn't a cleanup device, she's a monitoring device. And the reason for that is that marine cleanup is impossible, scale-wise. You don't start mopping up the overflowing bathtub before you've turned off the tap. So when I first moved to Newfoundland, there was no science that had been done on plastics in a coordinated way, and none that I could find about what was in the water. And so I was like, well, I need to go sample something. I didn't have a lab at the time. I didn't have any money or grants or anything. I didn't have equipment. I stretched a pair of baby tights over a Palm Wonderful bottle because it had that nice little cinched waist in those bottles. So you can pinch it and it works pretty well as a scoop. And I stood in front of the sewage outfall and scooped and scooped. It worked so well that when I got it back, it had a really robust sample. The size of the plastics were actually extremely small, much smaller than I thought they could be. You know, it just worked so well that I was like, oh, I should probably like coordinate this a little bit more and turn it into a legitimate tool, especially because the obligations I have are also to food webs and food sovereignty. And so we sample freezers, by which I mean we sample the fish and birds and seals that people eat. And those are people who don't have grants, who don't necessarily have universities, do not have labs also. And so here is a technique that met all of this and also answered the problem of like, how do you tell if there's plastics in your water? So there was one point where I was like, I'm going to try and make a non-plastic baby legs. That gets really expensive really fast. And there's very few things that are accessible that have the fine mesh of baby tights to get plastics that are that small without having to make them by hand through skills that are almost completely inaccessible even to people like me. So the sort of intuitive, quick and dirty, do it yourself, solve a problem, throw some materials at it method of her design works so well that it's been very hard to improve on it. My hope for Baby Legs as a monitoring device is that more types of people that are usually represented in knowledge production, scientific knowledge production, get into the process of knowledge production so that they can take whatever Baby Legs finds and point it back up pipe to hold industry, plastics, lobbies, governments accountable. She's designed to try and pivot power as much as possible.